You came here to see my student dorm, right? I can show you around. But I just was running in the forest, so I need to grab a glass of water from the kitchen. By the way, I'm Narmina from studying Sweden. What are you waiting for? Let's go! Obviously, we need to open the door. Yeah, one more door right for the corridor. That's the first point actually about my accommodation. It is very safe and secure. You open multiple doors to reach your glass of water. It's not all about safety or security. I at the same time find this kind of arrangement organized and disciplined, responsibility-wise as well. You know what belongs to where, who is responsible for what, when and in which part of the building. Especially when it comes to cleaning and recycling. And by cleaning, I only mean the corridor and the kitchen, of course. Since we're in the kitchen, I can tell you a bit more about it. It's a shared corridor kitchen for 10 people who live in the corridor rooms. We have pretty much everything necessary to become master chefs. Stove, oven, fridge, microwaves, kettle, dishwasher as well. Yeah, and you can find these facilities more or less in both types of the kitchen, shared as well as the private kitchens in the apartments.
After starting to live here, I became responsible for and actually freer in my diet. I explored new, specifically plant-based dishes and learned how to cook them. Now I believe that kitchen is the most important part of home, where you can explore, learn, taste, fail, succeed, create and share. And sometimes it can be a shared success as well. But before I show you our shared success, let me briefly mention some facts about my student dorm while I'm cooking. Never forget your keys inside the kitchen, because if nobody else is home, then you'll need to climb from window or do some magic to get the keys. If anything needs to be repaired, you call the caretakers who come and fix immediately and for free. Although we clean it weekly, at the beginning of a new semester, the company arranges professional cleaning for the kitchen and the corridor. The entrance and the surrounding area of the building is cleaned several times a week. Tap water is very delicious in Sweden, so we drink directly from the tap. The heating and the temperature in the rooms are just lagom, which is a Swedish word and means not too much, not too little, just right. Now it's time to show you our shared success.
We will be baking kanelbullets. It is first time for me, so I'm very, very excited. I'm going to do it with my Swedish friend, August. Have you baked before?
Yeah.
Oh, you have.
I think flour is vetemjöl.
Okay, so vetemjöl flour. It's not too difficult, actually.
No, it's very easy.
Sweden is an easy country to live, like from cooking and baking Swedish things, from that to everything, to getting an education. I think it's okay.
This kitchen brings us together. The whole corridor becomes a home, and those 10 people eventually become a family, which is the biggest advantage of living in a corridor room. I can also practice different languages, like Persian and Swedish, with my corridor mates.
Hey, hur mår du?
Bra, tack.
Tack, bra.
Do you want chocolate?
You want to make me fat.
The only disadvantage is that you cannot be as flexible as you'd be in your private kitchen.
Okay, guys, I'll go to bed now and I'll do the dishes tomorrow.
Okay, I understand. Yes. Ooh, are you happy now?
I'm the kitchen monitor this week. Jag är köksvakt denna vecka. I'm in charge of the cleaning this week. Jag är städansvarig denna vecka.
So, yeah, that wasn't a right reaction, I guess.
Once a week, one of the corridor tenants have to take out the waste from the kitchen and clean both the kitchen and the corridor. The label hanging on my door is passed around. Separating waste is not very common back in my country. It definitely takes time and energy to do so, but once you analyze that you're serving a very important idea of sustainability and reusing the resources, it becomes natural and something you also want to contribute to. In this student dorm, as well as in the whole country, recycling is highly encouraged. When I say highly, I really mean it. We go even further in food waste separation, like only food which we put in a paper bag, in a separate box, and food with some other stuff, like with a tea bag, which we put in another box. It's time to show you the place which has been tolerating me and my emotions for the last 10 months. My room. My room, my best friend which has seen me both laughing and crying, passing and failing, exercising and eating junk food, dancing and singing. Both corridor rooms and apartments can be furnished or unfurnished. In the furnished ones, you've got a bed, desk, chair and a bookshelf. The rest, you arrange it to your liking and to your budget's liking. By the way, I need to go to my friend's apartment to water her plants since she's away. And I can show you her apartment as well. This part of the building is the ruling one. Most strict, punctual and serious boss ever. The laundry room. If you plan an appointment, which means book a time slot in the laundry room, then you cancel anything but this. Booking the laundry room is very simple. You do it in this machine. It's in Swedish, but I promise you'll get it immediately. Best part of living in a three-floor dorm is that you always have a time slot latest for the next day, and sometimes on the same day as well. Using the laundry room is free of charge, but you have around 2 hours to finish washing as well as drying your laundry, as you can't open the door later. On the same floor, which is the basement, we have three more important places. The storage room, the sauna, and the gym. Gym's also free of charge. You just pay some amount of money as a refundable deposit to get the keys. In front of the building we have benches, grills and planter boxes. Oh, also outside we have gatherings and food together, organized by the Tenants Association, which also contributes to the process of becoming a huge family. You watch the video from Study in Sweden YouTube channel and check out more videos from the channel to learn more about living and studying in Sweden. We will upload more videos, so make sure to turn on the bell button to be notified about a new video. Hej då!